Here we go for episode 4 then. In this video, we're going to look at the guitar tracks. The guitar tracks are really important in Eastside, and there are 3 of them. They're all similar, but we've got some extra things that we need to put in for some of them. So the way I've got mine laid out, the most important guitar part, the one that happens at the beginning, is electric guitar 3. It's pretty easy to identify because it's the only one which is actually playing at the beginning. Now, it could be that you haven't got that as electric guitar 3. You might have that as electric guitar 1 or electric guitar 2 even. It depends how your file names have been downloaded and imported. But for me, it's electric guitar 3. So we're going to do this one in 2 layers. And we're actually going to reuse what we've already recorded for our bass track. And we're just going to adjust it slightly. So there's no MIDI keyboard involved in this track. So I'm going to create 2 new software instrument tracks. I'm going to set the first one up, and I'm going to go for guitar. I'm going to use this classic clean sound. That works quite nicely. Then I'm going to duplicate that, so I've got 2 of them. Okay, now if I were using the keyboard, that would give me that sound, which isn't a perfect match for what's going on in the rest of it, but it's a good match, so we're going to go with it. So we're going to reuse what was in the bass. So let's call this electric guitar 3 bottom layer, and let's call this electric guitar 3 top layer. Okay, now the bass, I'm going to copy the bottom layer first. And funnily enough, I'm going to put that on the bottom layer of the guitar track. Except it was in the wrong track when I selected it. So I put the playhead back to the beginning, select the guitar 3 track, and paste in. So I should just probably go over that process again, shouldn't I? So I clicked on here, the Liverpool bass track. Now you can either go Windows C to copy, or you can right click and go copy, then click in the new track, put the playhead back to the beginning, and you can either go Windows V, or you can right click and paste. Okay, now we don't want all of it, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut it back. So I've just got 2 bars worth. We're going to use the loop tool for this. So this gives us okay, now that is in the wrong octave. I've also been spelled electric. Let's fix that. There we go. That is in the wrong octave. It's too low. We want that, but we want it up higher. Or actually, is it? Hang on a second. Let's just listen again. Nope, I'm completely wrong. That is absolutely fine as it is, so we can just throw it out using the loop tool. Now, how many different repeats do we have? I think it just keeps going until the point where the bass stops in bar 12, but it's worth checking. Stop. There we go. So if we take the loop tool, top right hand corner, and we pull that out. So we're going to need 1 more note. There we go. And then we can copy that, same as before, and put it into bar 13. Now there's another stop in bar 20. So again, we take it and we check that. Okay, now one of your assessment criteria states that you need attention to detail in order to achieve a distinction. And things like making sure the gaps are in the right place, they are definitely demonstrating attention to detail. So I don't think we've got any more stops after that for a bit. Let's have a listen from bar 21. Okay, so I just missed off one note. Put that in. And then there's the gap there. And that's where all of our other parts are finishing. So that's a good spot for us to finish. We've got a minute's worth of track, and that's absolutely fine. So that bottom layer is complete. For the top layer, I'm going to copy the little loop that we created for the top layer of the bass. I'm going to paste that in. Now, do you remember the slide? Okay, this one has a slide as well. So let's see how that has turned out so far. Okay, so the slide doesn't quite work in its current form, does it? So let's fix that first of all. I think the problem is that the slide is too big. So I'm just going to adjust one of these. It was up here. I'm just going to turn it down so it doesn't bend quite as far. That's still a bit too much, and we might need to make some adjustments. Yeah, so let's take it down even further. It's getting better. Again, trial and error. That will do nicely. So as before, take the loop tool and adjust it to exactly the same length as your upper part. Paste it in there. Paste it in there. Paste it in there. And adjust it. So we've got our layers. So the two layers together sound like this. That'll do nicely. Okay, and then I'm going to take out the original guitar 3 track to the end of what we've got, and let's hear it in context. Now it needs some balancing. Need some effect applied to it as well, perhaps. When I was young, I fell in love. I used the old arms, man, that was enough. It's sticking out a little bit, but it will do nicely for the time being. Okay, the next track that we're going to have a look at doesn't actually start at the beginning. It starts at bar 21, I think it is. It's this slightly dreamy sort of guitar line, which is going to be a great opportunity for us to put reverb on later. Really, really, really quite heavy reverb. So we're going to start with that. So this one, again, there are two layers to it, so I'm going to add two software instrument tracks. Change this to guitar. Let's go with classic clean again. Why has it put it there? Don't understand GarageBand sometimes. There we go. So we'll call this electric guitar 2 upper layer. And electric guitar 2 bottom layer or lower layer. Ah, just realized I've missed out an opportunity to take a screenshot. So let's do that. So let's do that now. Where are we up to? Screenshot 13. Here I am recording the first of 3 guitar tracks. Really struggling with the word electric today. I did this by copying and pasting the bass loops that I had created above. I needed to alter the slide on the bass track to make it match the original. I did this using the editor. Okay, and that one's really quite simple. All we did was a bit of copy and pasting, but always good to screenshot as you go along. Okay, so where were we? We're doing with Electric Guitar 2, which we said started at bar 21. Let's put Electric Guitar 2 back on. Okay, so the notes for this are quite straightforward. Okay, it's a harmony part of what has gone before. So again, all we need to do is record one pattern of it. We'll start at bar 21. Here we go. Okay, nice and simple. Open the editor, quantize it. Just realized I didn't tell you what the notes are like I normally do. So we have C sharp, B, E, A, B. So don't play a wrong note like I did. C sharp, B, E, A, B. Okay, that's what you want for the first layer. And let's... I think it just goes all the way up to bar 29 without stopping. So it's just a really simple loop. Yes, it is. Okay, so we go up to bar 29. Okay, and we're going to do pretty much exactly the same thing for guitar 2. I didn't mention transpose. It's worth mentioning I'm on the one up here. I'm on green up, which is why it's coming out a little bit higher, because this is a higher part. For the second layer, you actually only need one note. Okay, it's just this A over and over and over again. Watch me do it. Oh, I'm recording on the same track. That's no good. Again, attention to detail. Looped out too far on the track above. Let's get some quantization on it. Okay, now that works okay. But I'm hitting some of the notes a bit too hard. This is quite a dreamy part. So what I'm going to do is in the editor, I'm going to turn the velocity down a touch. So the velocity is how hard I press the key. So it's a bit like the sort of the amount of energy given to the note. So I'm going to take it down. I'm going to take it into the 30s. Now, you can't adjust multiple notes simultaneously, which I always think is a bit of a... bit of a shame. But luckily, we haven't got very many of them. I'm not going to make them all exactly the same. That'll make it sound a bit robotic. A couple of 32s, a couple of 30s. Maybe one in the 20s. Why not? Just taking the edge off it. And like I said, we're going to come back later and we're going to adjust. We're going to add some effect to make it even dreamier. I'm going to add some reverb, but that doesn't come until later in the project, so we're not going to do that now. So that's adjusting velocity. We need to do some of that in the upper part as well. Now, this is a loop, so this one we only need to adjust a little bit. So let's go to the 30s again. Just, as I said, taking the edge off of that. This is all good technique that can go in your right up. Just listen to that. That's better already. There we go. Okay, so what do we need to do now? Of course, we take a screenshot. Screenshot 14. Really nice detailed project here. Here I am recording the second of the guitar tracks. This one is a harmony version of the first, and I recorded it with the MIDI keyboard. This is quite a dreamy track, and as a result I reduce the velocity on all of the notes to make it sound less harsh and accented. Put in an extra line here, which again I did with the layer. Whoops. Here we go. And let's see how these are fitting together at this point. Oh, need to take the original track out. Let's not forget that. Let's see how things are sounding now. Tonight, we can go anywhere we want. Drive down to the coast, jump in the sea. Just take my hand and come with me. It's going to need some balancing and some effects on things later, but it is sounding really nice. Okay, the last one that we've got is guitar one, electric guitar one. I think that starts at bar 20. Let's put it on solo, otherwise we won't know. Bar 21 it starts at. Okay, now it's only one note. Okay, again, it's that... It's that A that we're going to need. Going to need a track before I can play anything. So let's put in another software instrument track. We could have actually duplicated one of the classic cleans because that's what we're going to use. But we're going to alter this one in a very important way. We're going to put some delay on this one. Now, this is an effect, so really it should come later. But if you don't do it now, you might forget about it, or I might forget about it. So it's just the one note. It's just an A, okay? And it looks like it doesn't start until bar 25. It does. It's very, very quiet from 21 until 25, and it is there. Listen. Okay, so we're going to do two things with that. First of all, we're going to apply delay to it, which is an effect, to make it have that sort of echoey coming back. Delayed effect, and also we're going to automate the volume because at 25 it suddenly becomes a lot louder. Now what we don't want to have to do is have to turn up the volume slider as we get to bar 25. So we can ask the computer to do that for us. Okay, so a really easy pattern to record. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the delay and I'm going to turn the delay on the smart controls all the way up. Now, this should be open when you select a new sound. If it isn't, press B. Okay, and then the smart controls will appear. And that is applying lots of delay to this. So when I press the keys now... Okay, it sounds like I've pressed the key lots of times, even though I haven't. Okay, now when you actually record for this is not so important. It's just adding some texture. So long as it's all on that A, it'll be absolutely fine. Okay, so here we go. Okay, so nice and simple. Open the editor. Quantize it. Okay, and that gives us this. Okay, now I said I wanted it quieter from 21 to 25. So I'm going to press A, which opens automation. And this line here, this grey line, represents the volume of the track. So if I turn this up and down on the fader, if I turn this up and down on the fader, you can see the line moves up and down. Now, we want to get the computer to do that automatically for us. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the grey line where that part starts. And you can see it turns yellow. Click again, and it adds a dot. Now, at the start of bar 25, I'm going to add, or just before 25, I'm going to add another dot. And just after 25, another dot. I'm going to turn this right down. I'm going to go minus 20.7. That'll do nicely. Okay, and then minus 20.7 on this one as well. And then what we want is for it to suddenly become louder at 25. So what this line is telling us is that it wants the computer to turn the volume down and then suddenly turn it up for bar 25. Okay, so let's have a listen to that. Let's see how that works out. So quiet, and then okay, now we can probably make it a little bit more sudden there, so let's put them directly over the top of each other. Okay, they're not quite in line, so let's actually put the playhead on 25. Okay, now again, just showing a bit more sequencing technique. So in order to show that, what do we need to do? Of course, we need to take a screenshot. There are two things to say about this. Screenshot 15. Nice and neat, central. There is a third guitar part, which is even more dreamy. Can't spell. And ambient. And the second one. This is only a single note, but uses the effect delay. I added this to the track using the smart controls menu, and that's activated by pressing B. I simply turned the delay all the way up. I also wanted the volume to change in the middle of this. Like the original does. To achieve this, I used automation. Where the door, let's say, automatically changes the volume based on parameters set by me. I had it quiet. Oops. What happened there? Don't know. Wasn't typing. I had it set quietly from bar 21 to 24 and then increased the volume. Okay, now we should probably actually have two screenshots for this. We've got one on the editor, which is great. Let's have one of the smart controls as well, because we talked about those. And there's absolutely nothing wrong with having two on the same page. And saying screenshots 15 and 16. Because they're connected. And there we go. That gives us our guitar parts with a whole load of really interesting sequencing technique. Let's take out that original track. And you can see that now we're really starting to get quite a lot of, you know, we've now done the majority of this opening, which is great. So let's have a little listen, see how this goes. Now, as I've said already, we're going to need some balancing. That guitar part is sticking out, but that's fine, that's coming later.
I fell in love, I used the old arms, man, that was enough. Then we grew up, started to touch, used to kiss underneath the light on the back of the bus. Oh no, your daddy didn't like me much, and he didn't believe me when I say you were the one. Oh, every day she found a way out of the window to sneak out late. She used to meet me on the east side of the city where the sun goes in.
Fantastic. Okay. Oh, there's that delay still ringing on a little bit. Great. So there's how to do our guitar tracks. We're nearly there in terms of inputting. Next episode, I will show you how to do the synth parts, which, funnily enough, are very similar to the guitar parts we've done in this episode. I'll see you then.